Okay, thank you, Diogo. Good morning and good evening to everybody. And I'd like to thank the organizer for having invited me and for making this conference possible in these hard times. The topics of my talk is to study deterministic mean field games where the generic players controls his acceleration. And these are joint works with Yves Du, Claudio Marchi, and Nicoletta Chu. Please feel free to ask me in any moment whatever you want. The plan of my talk is the following. I will briefly introduce the problem, the deterministic mean field games, and then I briefly present through three examples where the Hamiltonian is non-coercive. And then I will focus my attention at the third case, the case where we have control on the acceleration. And I will explain the unconstrained case, the existence and the representation formula for the solution of the unconstrained case. And then in the last 10 minutes, 15 minutes, I will speak about two works in progress with Yves Du, Claudio Marchi, Nicoletta Chu, where we have control on the acceleration, but we have also constraint. The first case, we have state constraint and also a bound on the control. And the second case, we have only state constraint. Okay, let us start. In the pink box, you can see the deterministic mean field games system. The first row, we have the Hamilton-Jacobi equation. The solution U is the value function of a typical agent which follows a deterministic dynamics. Wait a moment, I have a red pointer, okay. And we know that we can associate to the Hamilton-Jacobi equation an optimal control problem, imposing a dynamics and a cost. The second equation is the continuity equation. M represents the density distribution of the agents and is a density of a probability measure. And then we have initial condition for M and the final condition for U. And these two equations are coupled by capital F. And the, another coupling is here in the final condition. Then capital F and capital G represents the interactions between the agent and the wood population. We will specify later the assumptions on the data, but I take here that M0, the initial distribution with compact support. And I want to say that this type of deterministic mean field games is mostly studied where H is coercive with respect to P. The simplest case, H, P squared. In our program work, we are interested to consider some cases where the Hamiltonian is not coercive. And then now I will show you three examples. The first one is an example in R2, where the generic player has a degenerate dynamics and has a forbidden direction at some starting points. And the second example is an example in R3, where the player follows a dynamics called of Heisenberg type, where the player has a forbidden direction at every point, at every starting point. And the third case is the main topic of the talk, and we consider a dynamics where the player control his acceleration. First example, simple example in R2. This is a joint work with Claudio Marchi, Carlo Mariconda and Nicoletta Chu. We consider the two components of the state variable x1, x2, and we take a h-bounded, which vanishes only in a point, for example, x1 equals 0. And we consider the following dynamics of the generic player. Note that in the second component, we have the presence of this degenerate term. Then, if we look at this picture, if the player starts, for example, from this point, he or she cannot go directly along the x2 axis. But if the player starts from another point, this or this, he or she can go in every direction. Hence, for some points, the points of x2 axis, the player has a forbidden direction. And note that if the player starts near the x2 axis, for example here, it's very costly for the player to go along his vertical line. If we take as cost, for example, this functional, we take this general alpha square and the term capital F and capital G encode the interaction with the population, This is the final cost. And with this cost, the Hamiltonian associated to this optimal control problem becomes of this type. And note that besides P2 square, we have a term which vanishes. Hence, the Hamiltonian is not coercive. And in this case, we can write the Minfield game system in this way. Note that in the Hamilton-Jacobi equation and the continuity equation, we have this degenerate term H square. Okay, second example, the player, the component are X1, X2, X3, follows the following dynamics. Note that the third component depends on the combination of the first and the second components. In this case, if the player starts from a point of R3, any point of R3, he or she cannot go directly along his vertical direction. Hence, in this case, the player has a forbidden direction in every starting point. We take, as in the example before, the cost function of this type, and the associated Hamiltonian becomes of this form. And note that also in this case, the Hamiltonian is not coercive. It degenerates when x1 and x2 are equal to 0. And note that we have a big difference between the two cases, the previous case and this case. And this is due to the type of degeneracy of the dynamics. For example, if we associate to the previous dynamics the matrix B of the coefficients, we see that if we compute the determinant of B times B transpose, this determinant is equal to 0 only where H vanishes. But if we take the matrix C, the matrix C associated to this Heisenberg type dynamics, We see that the determinant of capital C times capital C transpose is equal to zero for any x. And then to study the existence of the solution of the corresponding Minifield game system, we have to use for the two cases different methods. Third case, the main topics of this talk, we take the state variable, which is the couple XV. X represents the position of a player, and V represents its velocity. Hence, we write the problem where the dynamics control the acceleration in this way. We call it also double integrator dynamics. And note that in this case, not only we have some forbidden direction, but we have also forbidden regions. For example, if the player starts from the red point here, he cannot go directly on the left. And if the player starts from the blue point here, he cannot go directly on the right. And if the player starts from the red point and he wants to go on the left of the V axis, he has to decrease his velocity at this, to pass the X axis. At this point, his velocity is negative, hence he can go on the left and to pass the V axis will be negative. Is the only way to go on his left. Okay, we associate to this dynamics a cost, and our cost will be of this form. We take alpha square, we take the terms capital F and capital G, and we take also a term of the type V square, which represents the kinetic energy of the player. Note that we can add also a bounded term, a regular term, which depends on the state variable, but we omit it for the sake of simplicity. And then if we take this cost and with the dynamics of the double integrator, the Hamiltonian associated to this optimal control is of the following form. Note that the red term degenerates when V is equal to zero. Hence, due to the presence of this term, the Hamiltonian is not coercive. And note that in the Hamiltonian, we have the blue term, this blue term, which is unbounded. And then the Hamiltonian is unbounded. And now we are ready to write the mean field game system. I write in blue the state variable XV to better understand the dependence and the type of the degeneration. In the first equation, this is the first equation, the Hamilton-Jacobi equation. This is the continuity equation. Note that the drift term in the continuity equation contains as a first component the second component of the state variable. And here we have a gradient with respect to V of U. Okay, the assumption that we consider to get our results are that the capital F, the terms capital F and capital G are regularizing non-local coupling with bounded C2 norm. And we suppose that the initial M0 has a density which has a compact support and is Elder continuous. We want to find the existence of a solution, and then now we give the definition of solution, which is a couple, UM, with the following regularity: U as bounded, locally bounded first derivative, M is a measure for any T, is an absolutely continuous measure, and is continuous with respect to T, and U solves the Hamilton-Jacobi equation, the viscosity sense, and M solves the continuity equation in the sense of distributions. And what we want to prove, our main result, is the following. The system of mean field game has a solution UM, following definition here above. And very important, we want to represent M as a push forward of M0 through the characteristic flow phi, which is associated to this system. This system gives the optimal trajectories of the optimal control problem associated to the Hamilton-Jacobi equation. And this means that, roughly speaking, this formula means that for every starting point xv, the distribution of the agents m follows the optimal trajectories associated to this Hamilton-Jacobi equation. Okay. Some literature about deterministic mean field games and solutions in our sense. The existence and the representation formula for deterministic mean field games with coercive Hamiltonian was proved by Pierre-Louis Lyons in his lectures at Collège de France, and can be found in the lecture notes of Pierre Cardaliaguet. And I want also to cite the paper of Cardaliaguet at Icanlu, where we take some idea for something that we have to prove. Then I want to cite also the book of Diogo with Pimentel Boscaian, where a lot of results on existence and regularity of the solution of various mean field games systems are collected, and also the paper of Gomez Boscaian, where he studied an extended mean field game system of deterministic type. And the second group of citation are the paper related to the Lagrangian approach. This Lagrangian approach will be useful for constraint case. When we study the constraint case with control and acceleration, we have to relax the definition of solution. And then we take the definition stated by Kannarsa Kapuani, definition of mild solution. This type of solution was introduced by Benamou, Carlier, Sant'Ambrogio for unconstrained mean field games, and then stated for the constraint case by Kannarsa Kapuani. And I want also to cite a recent work of Kannarsa Mendico, where a problem similar to our problem is studied, but with different techniques. Okay, in this slide I write the classical mean field games, deterministic mean field game system in the coercive case, as proved by Pierre-Louis Lyons. We have the Hamiltonian AP square, and Pierre-Louis Lyons proved that the mean field game system has a solution is the same definition of our solution, and M can be represented by the push forward of the initial distribution N0 through the flow associated to the dynamics that in this case is the standard dynamics which gives the optimal trajectories. Okay. Now we recall our problem. Let us go back to our problem. As we have our mean field game system, which is where we have some unbounded terms and some terms which can degenerate. And this is the statement of our theorem, the existence of the solution, and a representation formula for M. Note that in this case, the system for the optimal synthesis has only the gradient with respect to V of U. Okay, which is the plan of the proof? The argument is a fixed point argument. We take a blue M and we find a U solution of the Hamilton-Jacobi equation. And this is the step one. But we have also to find fine properties of U to pass to step two. In the step two, we take the U found in pass one with the properties of U and of the associated optimal control problem, we prove the existence and uniqueness and the representation formula for the green M. And then in the next three or four slides, I sketch only the step for step one and for step two. But before, I want to point out the differences and the difficulties with the coercive case. We see that the Hamiltonian is degenerate, and this is due to the presence of the degenerate dynamics of the generic player. In this case, we cannot prove a contraction property, which is a key ingredient in the proof of Pierluis-Lyons, to prove the representation formula. And then we have unbounded Hamiltonian, hence some estimates of the value function hold only locally with respect to V. We do not have global estimates. And remark that the drift in the continuity equation is the couple minus V gradient with respect to V of U. And this drift is unbounded, and also the second component is unbounded, and it has a grow like V. Step one, we call small f, small g, the known functions, because here we have the blue M, and we study the following Hamilton-Jacobi equation. Then, it is not difficult to prove that the value function, which is the infimum of the cost functional, is the unique solution, is the unique viscosity solution of this Hamilton-Jacobi equation in the class of the functions which grow at most quadratically. But we need only fine properties of U. And then we need, for example, that the optimal trajectories does not bifurcate after the starting time. Then we have uniqueness of the optimal trajectories after the starting time. Note that in this case, in the case of the acceleration on the control, it is not difficult to prove this property, but in the other non-coercive case, For example, the second case, the dynamics of Heisenberg type in R3, we cannot prove this property. We cannot prove that the optimal trajectories are unique after the starting time. And then we have to change method to obtain the existence of the solution and representation formula. Then we can prove that U is Lipschitz continuous with respect to the variable X and only locally Lipschitz continuous with respect to V and T. Then we can prove the semiconcavity with respect to the state variable XV. And we can prove also, and this is a key ingredient, the optimal synthesis. The optimal synthesis says that the gradient of U in the point XV exists if and only if there exists a unique solution of this system. And the solution of this system is the optimal trajectory, starting from the point XV at time t. And then joining point 2 and point 4, we prove that this system has a unique solution for almost every starting point XV. And in this case, the optimal control law can be written as minus the gradient with respect to V of U. With such ingredients, we can pass to step 2 to study the continuity equation. We can prove this theorem. For any blue M, there exists a unique solution green M to the continuity equation with the following regularity, and M is the push forward of M0 by this flow, where U is the function founded in step 1. Found in step 1. Okay, then to prove this theorem, we have to prove existence and uniqueness. The next two slides we are devoted to the existence and uniqueness. Existence of a solution. To prove the existence of this solution, we have to use a vanishing viscosity method. But we have to apply this vanishing viscosity method not only at the continuity equation, but to the whole mean field game system. And if we call sigma the coefficient of the approximation, we prove that the couple U sigma M sigma converge to UM, where U is the solution that we found a step in step 1, and M satisfies the continuity equation with the drift, the gradient with respect to V of U. And to prove this result, we have to use a representation formula from stochastic optimal control problem, taking account that the coefficients are unbounded, and we need uniform estimates for U sigma and M sigma, especially on the semiconcavity of U sigma and on regularity for M sigma. Uniqueness, the uniqueness of M is obtained by the representation formula for M. If M is any solution of the continuity equation, then we prove that M is the push forward of M0 through the flow associated to the optimal trajectories, where the optimal trajectories solves this system. And if we denote by ET the evaluation map, to get this representation formula, we have to use, this is the first equality, the superposition principle proved by Ambrosio, Gigli, Savare in their book, which says that if M is a solution of a continuity equation with a prescribed drift which has a P integrability condition, then there exists a measure eta which is concentrated over the curves that satisfies a differential equation associated to this drift. And this is the first equality. The second equality uses a disintegration theorem, hence we can disintegrate the measure eta by a family of measure eta of xv. And the third equality takes account of the key ingredient, which is the optimal synthesis and the existence and uniqueness, the uniqueness of the optimal trajectories. And then, in our case, the measure on XV is nothing but the delta measure. And then we can write this equality and then representation formula. Okay. This is the unconstrained case, and now I briefly present the two results. These are work in progress for a constrained case. We have we still have the control on the acceleration, the double integrator dynamics, and we suppose, recall that x is the position of the player, v is his velocity, and we suppose that the position is constrained in the interval minus 1, 1. We consider this one-dimensional case, but we can repeat the same argument for the corresponding d-dimensional case. And we take also a control bounded in the interval minus 1, 1. Note that in this case, if the player starts from this black point, he cannot go along the red lines, but he has to go only along the blue lines. I mean that we can find these two parabola, black parabola, which delimitate the region where we have forbidden direction. Okay. In this case, we define the value function as before, but we have also to write the blue constraint on the trajectories and on the control. We write the dynamics and we define the viability set as the set of the couple XV, where the value function is finite. And in this case, in this constrained case, simple but constrained case, the difficulties that we have are the following for the study of the Hamilton-Jacobi equation associated to this problem. The viability set depends on t. In the next slide, we can see a picture of the viability set in this simple case. But in other case, it is difficult to study the property, the geometric properties of the viability set. And then, due to the presence of the constraint, we cannot prove the uniqueness of the optimal trajectories, which is a key point to obtain our previous result. And also, we cannot prove the regularity of the value function as before, in particular, the Lipschitz continuity. We only obtain a Elder continuity with exponent 1/2 with respect to the variable x, v, and t. Let us see the viability set in our case, in our example. Note that this set changes if t change, and note that on the up boundary and on the down boundary we have the line, the red line, and the black parabola. This is the picture of this viability set. Okay. And for this constraint case, we cannot find a solution as in the previous case. We have to relax the definition of solution. And then we define the mild solution. The mild solution is not defined in terms of Minifield game PD system, but follows the so-called Lagrangian approach, as we will see in the definition given by Cannarsa-Capuani. And we define a Minifield game equilibrium for M0 as a measure eta, which is defined on the set of admissible trajectories. Such a measure is such that M0 is the push forward of eta by the evaluation map in zero. And, very important, eta is supported on the set of all the optimal trajectories starting from the point XV, where in the cost we take as M the push forward of eta by the evaluation map. Okay, then this means that we need to determine for each possible optimal trajectory the number of agents that follow this trajectory. And then a measure, we have to find a measure on the set which has support on the set of optimal trajectories. And if we find this Minifield game equilibrium, then we build a mild solution, namely a couple UM, where M is the push forward of eta by the evaluation map, a U is the value function where in the cost we take M as this push forward. And to prove the existence of mild solution in our case, we follow the procedure of Cannarsa-Capuani. The main ingredient of their procedure is a closed graph property. We have to prove that the map gamma, which takes a couple XV and goes in the optimal trajectories starting from the point XV at time zero, has closed graph. Once we have this property, it is possible to prove the existence of mild solution. And to prove this property, the key ingredient is this approximation result of admissible trajectories that I can explain here in this picture, which says if we take any point, is the red point P in the viability set, and any admissible trajectory, admissible, not optimal, any admissible trajectory, and if we take any sequence of points pi which converge to p, then it is possible to find a sequence of admissible trajectories starting from pi which converge uniformly to the red one, and whose derivatives converge in L2 to the derivatives of the red one. And this is the key ingredient. This is the key ingredient for this case, and also for the second case that we are studying. In this case, we take only a constraint on the position of the agent. Also in this case, one-dimensional case, the constraint is the interval minus 1, 1. The value function is the infimum of the cost subject to this constraint. And in this case, the viability set is the region between these two lines, these two red lines. And note that these two half lines are excluded in the viability set. Also in this case, to get the existence of a mild solution, we have to prove a closed graph property. And to prove the closed graph property, we have to get a result of approximation of admissible trajectories. And here, this approximation result say that for any point in the viability set, as for example, if we take as arbitrary point this, the point 1, 0 or the point minus 1, 0, it is not easy to obtain this approximation result. Hence, I call this point special points, because near this point, we have to do a deep analysis to get the closed graph property. Okay. I finished future program. We want to study mean field games with control and acceleration, but with more general state constraint. Also, we want to study deterministic mean field games with other type of degenerate Hamiltonian and non-coercive Hamiltonian. Okay. Thank you for your attention.